I'll be talking about the condition in which patient has come to you with deafness, inability to hear, hearing problem. Remember, let's go to the anatomy first. Let me give a whiteboard so that we can little bit we can understand things. Now let's say, for example, this is what is the external ear. Let's say, for example, this is what an external ear we have. This is what is an ear canal that we understood. We have the eardrum here. We have the middle ear here. We have in the middle ear we have the malleus, incus, and we have the stapes as the ossicles which are there. And then we have the inner ear. We have cochlea. Of course, we also have a semicircular canals, but I'm talking about hearing, so I will just draw them with a dotted line. So whenever the sound waves are falling, going in your ears, sound wave first travels from the external ear. Now this sound waves, let's say, for example, this is that A is the situation where the sound waves are going in the external ear. Then we have the sound waves will vibrate the eardrum. Let's say, for example, B, we have the eardrum. Let me also have A is external ear, B is eardrum. Then these sound waves will produce movement in the ossicles. C is what we have in ossicles. The sound waves will travel through the ossicles. Ossicular chain from malleus to incus to stapes. Now this will vibrate the oval window. We have D is an oval window. D is the oval window, and then it will go to the cochlea. Remember, in cochlea we have organ of Corti, where we have an hair cells, which will then, let's say, for example, E is the cochlea. This hair cell will get stimulated, and then it will be carried by the nerve called a cochlear nerve. Then it will be carried by a nerve called as a cochlear nerve. Let's say, for example, F is a cochlear nerve. Now, to make you understand properly, let's say when the patient comes to you with decrease in the hearing, it can be several problems. It can be problem from A, B, C, D, E, F. So how are you going to differentiate? What exactly? Because hearing problem, symptoms will be going to remain the same. Symptom will be going to remain the same. So it can be problem in the external ear, problem in the eardrum, problem in the ossicles, problem in the oval window, problem in the cochlea, problem in the cochlear nerve, or you can say vestibulocochlear nerve. Now, by and large, now let's make it simple. If there is a problem from A, B, that is external ear, eardrum, C, ossicles, D, oval window, up to the cochlea. Now this is together comes in a problem where we have a conduction of the air is not proper, because air is getting, or I can not air but the sound, so not able the sound. So here we have ABCD mein problem kya hai, sound ke conduction mein problem hai up to the cochlea. So this type of hearing loss is called a conductive hearing loss, whereas E and F, that means cochlea and cochlear nerve, is a nerve problem. This is also called as a sensory neural hearing loss. So if you can see properly, causes apne ko idhar hi pata chal jayega when we understand about the anatomy. So anatomy mein we have external ear, middle ear and the inner ear. So problem can be there in the external ear, A, B. Problem can be there in the middle ear, C and D, or problem can be there in the inner ear, E and F. So ABCD tak jo problems hai usme apne ko one type of hearing loss called conductive hearing loss, because there is a problem of conduction of the air. conduction of the sound through an ear, whereas ENF is called sensory neural hearing loss. Sensory neural hearing loss, and this is what we're going to learn down the road in this presentation. So let's go to the presentation right now. This makes